this video, I will show you how to do the 3D parallax effect that Magnates Media uses in all of his videos. After watching this tutorial, you'll be able to recreate this 3D effect with any number of 2D images. We are going to recreate this animation from one of his latest videos. So let's get right into it. To recreate this animation, we will need two images. So the first one will be portrait of this guy, John McAfee, and the second will be the background. Both of these images I generated using an AI website. You can generate it yourself, or I'll just add the link to it in the description. We'll need to separate both the layers, the foreground and the background. We have John in the foreground and the background is just a scenery. And to have more depth in the background, you will separate all the layers of the background. This foreground will be in a different layer, this lake will be in a different layer, and this background will be in a different layer. The sky will be in a separate layer of its own. So I have divided the background to four layers. I'll add the project file of this in the description as well, so you can just skip all the cutting part. Now let's drag this project file into After Effects. Select the import kindness composition, keep this layer option as additive layer styles. Now click on OK and you will have your composition here. In the reference, you will see that the camera zooms out from the sun in the background to the main shot here. Before we do the animation, let us turn all the layers into 3D. If you can't see the 3D option, just click on here, toggle switches and modes, and click on this icon to turn everything into 3D. Now we'll add a camera onto the scene. So just right click here, new, and click on camera. Make sure that the preset is set as 50 mm, and we'll have an f-stop of 1.2 so that the depth of field is good, and everything else you can just keep it the same. Now click on OK. So we have added the camera as well. Now we will change the view to 2-view mode. Now all the layers are in the same distance to the camera. Here is our camera. If you just select here, you'll see that here is our camera and here are all the layers, this line. So now we have to take the layers in the background far from the camera. This is just a random image. I'll delete this layer. So it starts from here, the sky. The sky should be furthest back from the camera. So let's place it the furthest, somewhere around here. And the background should be somewhere around here, far from the camera but nearer than the sky. And we'll select the mid ground. It should be somewhere here in the middle. Now we'll select the foreground and keep it around here. Now you'll see that all the layers are in a different space from the camera, but in order to adjust it to the frame, we'll need to increase the scale. Let's just start scaling everything. Click on S to bring the scale and scale it properly. Same here. If you just line up this box to the outer layer of the frame, this should be fine. So now that we have adjusted the scale of everything, we can start animating the camera. So to animate the camera, just click on this camera, open up everything here, the transform section. So let's look at the reference. The animation ends at around 2 seconds here. So here at 2 seconds, we'll set a keyframe of the position and the orientation. Now go to the first frame, and if you just reverse the animation, you'll see that you have to zoom in. You have to zoom into the sun and rotate the camera a little bit. So for that, if you just increase the Z position of the camera, it will zoom in. Adjust the Y position as well and just rotate this orientation like this. Maybe you have to adjust the Y position like this. Let's hide the character for now. Let's turn it off like this and focus on the background. It should do a rotation like this. Now if you see that along the edges of the cutout, there are some dark frames coming up. So in order to fix this, we can just go to our Photoshop layer and check where the things are going wrong. You will see that here it is in the background. So let's just hide the mid-ground and stuff for now. And you'll see that here in the background, wherever the dark edges are, we can just use the clone stamp tool and fix the edges. Okay, so this is the background. We can just use the clone stamp tool and fix the edges here. Just make sure to select the correct layer and you can just fix along the edges. Let's save it now and see if the things are fixed or not. Yeah. So if you just extend the edges of most of these backgrounds using the clone stamps tool, the line should be fixed. Now if you go to the After Effects file, you'll see that Yeah, there are no weird lines between the layers. Now we need to smoothen out this animation. So in order to do that, we'll select the keyframes, press F9 on the keyboard to ease them, and click here on the graph editor, select the second keyframe, drag this out like this, select again, you have to drag both of them out like this. Now let's play it once. So now let's bring our main character on the screen. If we bring him, you'll see that he is on the screen the entire time. But we don't want him on the screen the entire time. We want him to come like after a bit of the animation is done. So for that, we will go here just before the 1 second mark and select his layer. Click on P to bring out the position keyframes. And at the end of the animation, let's look where our camera is ended here, right? So at the end of the animation, we'll click another keyframe. Now we'll go to the first keyframe and just drag him down the screen like this. Yeah, so that he doesn't come from the start. We can do the same thing with his keyframes as well. Click on F9 after selecting them and go to the graph editor and drag this out like this. Okay, it's not looking good, so we need to adjust the position and stuff from here. Let's start bringing him from here. So you just need to adjust the keyframes and the graph style in order to get the animation you want. I think it's a bit too fast in the beginning, so we'll just drag this stuff. The first keyframes are not looking that smooth for me, so you'll just adjust the keyframes here as well. Make them a bit slower towards the end. So yeah, you need to adjust the keyframes, position and the graphs in order to get the animation that you want. Yeah, looks good to me. Now you will see that in the reference, there's a slight zoom in at the end, something like this. So I'll do the zoom in as well. It's pretty simple. You just need to increase the Z position a bit more. Maybe a bit of the Y position as well. And slightly change the orientation, not this one, -2. Yeah, this is better. Now select the second keyframes and just adjust them as well, something like this. Yeah, the orientation thing, I need to decrease the We are done with the animation. Now the last thing we need to do is add some depth of field onto the scene. So for that, we will open up this camera option here. So the depth of field is on. Open the two view camera here. If you just click on the focus distance now and just move it, you'll see that the focus line is behind the background. So for the beginning, we'll bring the focus line to our background here. Something like this, and we can increase the aperture to around 500 to get a better depth of field. Maybe 500 is too much, let's keep it 350. Now let's go to the second keyframe, and here the focus should be at our main character here. So you can just adjust the focus line here. But before that, I forgot to press the keyframes. So here, click the focus distance keyframe, come here again. Now change the focus distance to something like this, and now at the end we need to adjust the focus distance to focus our main character again. Let's just select these keyframes and press F9 to ease them. So now you will see that the focus shifts from the background to our main character as he comes on the screen, and it stays on to him till the end. But if you have used a real camera, the focus shifting is not always that smooth. So in order to recreate the feel of a real camera, we can just play with the focus distance. Maybe in here, we can shift the focus a little bit to the background and then bring it back again to him so that it feels a bit natural. Yeah, just play with the focus distance, add some keyframes and try to recreate the feel of a real camera. Now let's play the animation and see how it looks. Yeah, and it's done.